White supremacy, neo-fascism, Nazi clowns, milk. Now more than ever, it is important to remember the true meaning of social justice. Your life might just depend on it.
Virtue Signal is a card game that parodies left-wing social justice activism. Here's how it works. In Virtue Signal, everyone roleplays as a different social justice warrior archetype. The base deck has 8, and each character has his own personality and unique activist superpower. The object of the game, then, is to attract followers to your character's cause, whatever that is. Followers attach to the character cards similar to dominoes, and the first warrior to have 15 followers is the winner. Pretty simple. Social justice activism is a contact sport, though, and things are going to get rough. While you're trying to build your coalition up, all the other players are trying to stop you, or even tear it down. The most common way is by accusing you of microaggressions. A microaggression is a bizarre accusation against your liberal person. Investigations into your past, slips of the tongue, problematic hand gestures, or more than likely something that makes no bloody sense at all. When a microaggression is played against you, it besmirches your progressive reputation and makes it harder for your coalition to grow. Enough accusations and your growth can be stopped entirely. Just as in real life, or unreal life if you prefer, your wounded liberal reputation can be fixed through virtue signaling. A virtue signal is an empty ritual of progressive piety that makes you seem like a really good person, and which probably doesn't help anyone or accomplish anything at all. The right kind of virtue signal removes the microaggression and lets you grow again. For example, if someone accuses you of cultural appropriation, you can signal your way out of clown jail by wearing the keffiyeh you bought in Palestine and wishing death by fire on the great Satan. Makes sense, right? Of course not, and that's the whole point. But wait, I can hear you thinking. How can you simulate what it's like to be a social justice activist when the rules of social justice activism are changing constantly? This game sucks, reported for hate speech. Well, it just so happens that we already thought of that, smartass, which brings us to plots. Plots are global modifiers that change the rules of the game. Some favor particular groups, some favor certain players, some bring the game to a halt, and others bring down fiery Armageddon. And then there's also one that returns the game state to normal, if that's what you're into.
Be gone, plot!
There are also a variety of special cards with unique effects, such as stealing followers from someone's coalition, or forcing them to get a job, or triggering them so badly that they run away from the game crying. These are just examples. Some are even worse. Of course, all these emotional scars can be avoided if you remember to play your safe space card and crayons and a juice box, you big baby. And that's pretty much it. The game is strategic and competitive, and by the end, you and your friends will certainly be traumatized for the rest of your pointless lives. Now, before you run and tell Grandma that you were oppressed by a card game you saw on the interweb, we want to be clear that while we pulled no punches, we tried to make sure that all the punches were aimed up. This parody mostly attacks people who use these issues cynically for their own gain. And that's never a bad thing. If you like it, back our campaign and we'll send you a copy. And if it does well, we'll set to work making the alt-right expansion, which is definitely something we had planned from the beginning and not a shameless cash grab. Because we're equal opportunity offenders, and that makes it okay.